This one has a situation where you're mixing hot and cold water. And sometimes to make sense out of this, it helps to think of them as being separate. In other words, let's just pretend that there's a division between the two. Of course, we have heat going from hot to cold. That'll just help us make sense out of the math and what to do. So what do we know? Well, so we have, let me see, so we have, this is the cold water. And I'm going to call this T cold 1. And then I also have, this is the hot water. And this is T hot 1. And let's see, what else do we know? What is the temperature afterward? So it's asking for the final temperature. And we should know that it's going to be same for both the hot and the cold water. They're going to end up the same. And so I might just, instead of writing H2 and stuff, I'm just going to say T final, or well, we'll just call it T2. Okay, and what else do we know? Well, let's just start from there. Remember, we always usually just say, well, what can I do with this information? Well, we're used to using our equation QSMAT. So let's just start in with this. Let's start in with, let's look what the cold water does. I'll go ahead and put the units for this. So, T2, actually, I'm just going to call that T because it's what we're solving for. So this will be our T2, and then T1, we want our, this is our T. Cold one will be 20. Okay. So I'm just going to multiply that through. Okay, and we'll talk about sig figs after. This one kind of gets complicated on the algebra, so we'll treat the sig figs a little bit differently. So on this step, you guys, I'm just multiplying all of this and then multiplying it by t, and then all of that times 20. That's this times 20. Sometimes I get people on that because, algebra and chemistry, and maybe I'm not showing every step. So anyway, so let's do the same thing for the hot water. And this, of course, is the TH1. Okay, and then we'll multiply that through or distribute that. Okay, well, great. We have two things, two equations, and it looks like we can't solve it. We have too many unknowns here. But the thing is, we know a relationship between these two. Remember that we know that the Q for the hot is equal to the negative Q for the cold. And when you make that statement, it doesn't matter which one you put the negative sign on, as long as it's showing that they have opposite signs. So what I'm going to do is just take that and say, okay, let's put this down here. QH equals negative QC. So then I'm going to plug in. I'm going to take this right here and plug it in down here. And then for the QC, I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to take this and put it in right here. And I don't want to lose that negative sign. I was about to. Okay, and from there, it's just algebra. I'm going to gather up my T's on one side and then divide, just algebra. So anyway, I'm going to kind of show that pretty fast. Let's see. Oops. Very neat. Okay, so that's, I wanted to show you this one because it's a little bit more complicated. And that's basically how it's set up. And the trick there is to, again, treat the hot and the cold water as though they're not mixing. So a couple things. First of all, you probably noticed I was really ignoring the whole sig fig thing. And that's, we're kind of getting to the point in the class where when you start doing all this algebra and stuff, we're not going to keep track of sig figs on every little part, because in reality, when you get to higher up classes and you start doing all the using all these equations, there's actually a fancier way to keep track of the error than using just significant figures. And so what I would say in a case like this, where you go through so many steps in algebra, just look at your answer at the end and see, you know, with your given, kind of what would make sense. And in this case, what I would probably look at is the temperatures that were given. They were known to 1 degree. They didn't have anything after that. So when I come up with 30.2 for a second temperature, that, you know, doesn't really make sense that we could get that. So I'm, you know, we didn't know the tenth digit on these. So why would I know the tenth digit there? So I'm going to just make the judgment, and I'll give you some leeway on this. When you do a lot of algebra and you come down to the end, make a judgment on what seems right for the number of sig figs. Okay, another thing I wanted to tell you is that, oops, there is another way to solve this problem. And it's essentially using a weighted average. And if you know how to do that and you do it that way, that's fine. That's fine. And then the other thing is, on this problem, you can tell if the answer makes sense. Because when you're given these numbers, we're mixing water at 20 degrees and water at 37 degrees. We're going to expect the final temperature to come out between those, right? And if you made a mistake on your algebra, and you somehow came out with a temperature that was hotter than your hot, that wouldn't make any sense. So that's another thing you can do, is kind of see if the answer makes sense.